I did just hold on to this the whole thing. So, how long ago did you start YouTube and why?
Oh my god. I forgot it. I started YouTube back in 2014. Honestly, I don't know why. I was bored one day. It was back in my foster home. And I didn't go to school for a while because shit happens.
Your video because there's so much shit on your
because we end up doing so much weird shit. And I'm always having sugar because Robin knows that, okay, if I feed Jack sugar, sugar is gonna make him fuck. Give me drugs for that. So, it's actually one of my favorite things to do, and I really miss doing it because Lockhart has been one of my most requested characters because I was apparently very funny as him.
What's your Twitter tag?
Twitter is Jack Apocalypse, which is my real name.
Jack Apocalypse.
Jack Apocalypse, like Jack O P A. What's my name?
Hi, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
So you said you have a job.
Yeah.
How do you find having a job and trying to be YouTube? At least when you did do YouTube, like, did you find it difficult? And if so, what parts did you struggle with?
Honestly, when I did YouTube and my job, when I worked as a skincare vanity professional at the body shop, it was really hard because I worked a lot of night shifts. And that means I would have to get up early to catch natural light and have time before work. So I would get up early and do my YouTube things, which would take a few hours. Then I would go straight to work and work a full shift, go home. And then I would probably want to edit or actually, you know, sleep. So I would have really long days with a lot of things going on. And sometimes I would have time for doing my editing for a while, so we long breaks between videos. You won't get anywhere doing something just for views, or you will probably, but you won't like it. I tried, or not really tried. I was brought into YouTube with a lot of requests and a lot of expectations, like, oh, you're gonna have to do this, you're gonna do that, and if you don't do what you enjoy, it's gonna be shitty because you're gonna spend hours and hours in work filming, refilming when the camera dies on you, and editing in a shitty program that won't allow you to load files, save files, fuck up your shit, there's my language again, and you don't want to do that.
It's PG-13. Anybody who has a problem with this language can, well, I'll let you do the rest.
Yeah, that's good, because I curse a lot, but like, if you do get into YouTube, do what you want, because you don't want to spend hours doing something. Otherwise, what can I do? Try to find a place in your community where you know you feel that you belong. Because I found my place before. I was really into cosplay. I still kind of like cosplay. I just got kind of tired of it because I tried to get out and have more fun, but shit happens. Force your friends to be in your video. was basically for about half a year here, dressing very, very feminine. Like, we taught tons of makeup long hair every day, almost all the time, because it felt like, in a way, I was fucking good. I know I'm a guy, but you think I'm a girl, and I don't pass as a guy, so when they call me she or I'm fucking with them. and over time, as I got comfortable, I could have days where I still wanted to be feminine. Like today, I'm not very super masculine, but I'm not exactly what you would call a fuckboy either. I'm a Connor. Sorry. So it's really just kind of like climbing the stairs. You have to get on top of the stairs to reach your level of comfort, I guess, if that makes sense. And I started at the bar, I climbed up, I fell a few steps, like my butts, you know. So now I'm on top of the stairs, and some days I dress up like this, some days I go out full, cutesy, whatever, on a plane. And some days I just look like this mom, my boyfriend's clothes. So I guess that's the answer. I have questions.
Going to other countries, how exactly do you organize everything and deal with like new places?
Actually, I don't know. I've always been like someone who likes traveling, both within my country and outside. Like, my goal is basically to travel to different places I can before I die, which may be today, 10, 50 years, I don't know. So I always take the chance to travel when I can. I always try to remember, you know, like, we're all people, we have our cultures, Swedish. we have a different system. I always try to look things up beforehand, so I know a little bit about the area, the country, anything that can make me like handy. So, like, for example, I just came back from Japan like a week ago. I still kind of feel like, where am I? But, yeah. I just kind of adapted really quickly, so I don't know how to explain it, but yeah, looking at things beforehand really helped me. And now I have been here 5 times. People think I live here when I move around like that, and when people start speaking to me with really, a really heavy accent, I go like, so what? I don't live here, I just live where I do. So yeah, I lost track of what I was saying about that.
Next question.
How different would you say Sweden is to England? Because my best friend is Swedish and we're contemplating moving in together, but we don't know whether to move in here or over there.
Bunch of assholes.
Yeah, that's exactly what I was thinking. No, certainly. I think British people, they are much more compliant to the open when I come here. Like, Swedish people, you know, like, I don't see you. I'm here on my own. Sit somewhere else. Like, I hear people are like, cheers, mate. And I'm like, I don't know you. Bye. Yeah, I'm really awkward in Swedish, typically in Swedish. Sweden land, we are very, you know, we try not to say what we think, we just give you the bitch, retching, resting bitch face, and I think we're just more introvert. Overall, I like Britain because people are very open and expert. I get help with everything, like, I have a handbag, so I was like, would you need help? Stuff like that is really all like amazing, and I enjoy coming here for that. So don't go to Sweden and expect people to be nice, because we're actually really cold hearted assholes. Yeah, go.
I was gonna say anyone else, but I was assuming when you have something else to add to.
Sorry?
Do you have something else to add there, or is it time for the next question?
Yeah, go on, go on.
Next question, anybody? Anybody at all?
Also, yeah.
Ah, there we go.
food, don't get me started, it's the best food you can get in Sweden. I am not kidding.
Serious question though. If you were given an opportunity to do YouTube full time, I mean, would you instantly make that jump now that you're in a comfortable position with, you know, your normal job and stuff like that?
I could ask this question a while ago because I've had a lot of my colleagues quitting their job for better jobs, better positions, new jobs, whatever. I was put in a position to just imagine, because I was quite pissed at one colleague, but I wanted to do nothing for her. I was just sad because she had told me about applying for a job while everyone else is going, because she had been saying, oh, I'm going to stay here with you guys, and then, bye. You see Swedish people? Yeah, assholes. Even to our own kind. We talked about it and we said, I don't know what I would have done if someone asked me, hey, we want to employ you as a full-time YouTuber doing the stuff that you love. I don't know what I would have said. I love my job. I love the people at my job. I don't like the elderly people who comes in and yell at me, but I like the rest. So honestly, I don't know what I would do. YouTube is a very nice job if you can do this full time, because you're basically self-employed. You get to travel a lot, mostly, from my past experiences, and you get to do fun stuff, meet new people. You can be very, very creative and very, you know, flexible. But also, it's kind of, you know, hard, you know, because you have to put a lot of pressure on yourself to make sure shit gets done, and you can't blame anyone else because it's you, you're your own boss. So I guess it's a 50-50 answer that I would love it, but I would love to, how do you put this? I would love to have like a more clear plan of what I want to do, because right now I'm in the middle of a life crisis. I'm a 22-year-old and I'm in a 40-year-old crisis already. Like, when do I want my children to be my children? Like, when do I want children? What do I want to do for the rest of my life? I don't know. But also, it would be really fun to do a lot of YouTube work that could help younger people with, you know, social issues, family issues, trans, queer issues, because it's always been important to me, which is why I got an education as like sex ed teacher, whatever. But if I could do that, it would really be important to me. It's a great thing, but there's also a lot of other people out there doing this job already. So I guess the department still would have to stick with it.
Any other questions? Those are my questions. This is my people. It's a respect to all the other people. As I'm sure you know. So any other questions at all? Well, yes, maybe.
I'm used to it.
Because I recognize the one on the left from somewhere. How's the episode there? Yeah. Hiya. Whoa. What's the one on the right? What's the tattoo on the right?
Basically, your left arm. What's your tattoo?
Yeah, the big one. He made this for me because I have a huge secret. So it's, I'm 6 foot tall. Because my amazing friend Anna, who's an artist, she works at a tattoo shop, and what? Okay, it's 25 minutes. You made a good job.
Well, I said we probably have time for a few more questions.
I seriously can't talk right now. It's Sunshine City. It's like an amazing, huge mall with all kinds of stores you would ever want to visit. And also, it's close to the geek shops and stuff. So we definitely need to go there. Who's yelling at me? Who did I offend now? What else? I don't know. I just went to so many places. Eat all the kind of sushi you can have. The price is the best sushi ever. Just go to your pad and leave it. And don't do stupid shit like me.
Hey, ladies and gentlemen, I think that's about all we've got time for. So can we have a big hand for Jack? And how long are you going to be here? Is it just an hour as well weekend?
Anything.
Oh, okay.
It's not Japan, but...
There we go.
Thank you for coming. I love you.